between the victims seem to me to be the decision made on the balance is choosing this. It seemed to me not so much in the award to Prince Philip himself, but in terms of what it says about the future, about a self-image for the country and for our country's system of awards, I just found it beyond belief.
Has this changed your view about the judgment of the Prime Minister?
What worries me about it is not whether Prince Philip did or did not deserve an Australian knighthood. I frankly think that's a very, very, very low-level issue of no importance to virtually anyone, including Prince Philip. I think why there has been the overwhelming outcry about it is because it does sort of tend to say something about a Prime Ministerial view of the future, a Prime Ministerial view of the nation. And I think it's that sort of identity issue where this has really struck a raw nerve with, I think, most modern.
Do you think that Australians or many Australians would be so dismayed about this that they might actually start seriously thinking about a republic?
I hope so. I occurred to me to suggest that we make Tony Abbott an honorary member of the Australian Republican movement to services to the cause, because he has helped galvanise an issue which has obviously been hard to galvanise into a top-of-mind issue, and perfectly understandably so. But it's certainly, I think, has lifted the debate to the public consciousness.
The Australian Climate Institute has released a report today warning that the health of sportsmen and women is now at risk because of climate change. The report urges immediate action on heat policies at both the elite and community levels. The CEO of the Climate Institute is John Connor.
Well, we saw at the Australian Tennis Open significant complaints from a number of the professional players, and because there was confusion about the heat policy to be applied. Similarly, in the cycling tour down under last year, where the state policies had applied